Welcome back, guys, to another Clash Royale video, and today we're back on my second account, back on the road to Arena 9 as a level 8. Still using this Hog Rider deck. I got rid of the Elixir Pump in there because of course, the nerf, but I'm probably going to be using this deck all the way up to Arena 9, just because it's the deck that I have the most experience with, and sitting here at almost 2,800 trophies, things are getting pretty tough, so I don't want to venture out and try different strategies that I don't have experience with. But before we begin here, I want to give a quick shout out to another YouTube channel, which I've recently discovered, and that is Kairos Time Gaming, who puts out excellent educational content that I think you guys would really benefit from. So I highly suggest you check him out. I will put a link in the description below as well as the comment section. But like I said, his videos are really educational, and I think they'll help you guys out. Let's go ahead here, take a look at one replay, then we'll finish off with some live battles. So here we are, guys, facing off against a level 10 as a level 8, who is rocking a spawner deck. And as you can see from down there, my reaction facing off against a level 10. Two level difference in this battle, dropping down a bunch of WoW bombs here. Now, I haven't played this account on ladder since my previous Road to Arena 9 video, which was probably about a week and a half ago. Gonna do an immediate counter push on the opposite lane as soon as he uses the Barbarian Hut on the right hand side, because with the spawner decks, you have to punish them for placing down a hut like that, because a Barbarian Hut does cost 7 elixir, and as you can see, we did decent damage to that tower there on the left hand side, bringing it down to 710 health. But the problem with facing off against a spawner deck is, earlier on in the battle, you're able to do some decent damage to a tower, but later on, they get so many buildings down that they just overwhelm you with so many troops on the field. So you have to try and prevent them as best as you can from getting multiple buildings down. So I'm going to go ahead and use a fireball here, damage that tower, damage the furnace, as well as the Barbarian Hut. And my opponent makes one big mistake throughout this entire battle. He keeps dropping all of his buildings on the right-hand side, right next to his tower, which allows me to get huge value for my fireballs, damaging all of his buildings as well as the tower with one fireball. If you're using a spawner deck, you have to space out all of your buildings depending on what kind of spells your opponent has. If they have a rocket in their deck, if you place down the Spear Goblin Hut in the middle between both towers next to the King Tower, they can't actually rocket the tower as well as the hut with one rocket. If your opponent has a lightning spell, then you have to spread things out even more because the lightning has a much wider radius. But like I said, he keeps making the mistake at placing down all of his buildings next to his tower, allowing me to get value from my fireball. But unfortunately, my fireball is only level 6, meaning it doesn't do too much damage to the buildings as much as it probably could. And later on, he's able to build up a pretty strong force as all those buildings continue to pump out troops. Now, his tower on the left-hand side, sitting at 182 health, so all I really need is a fireball or one hit from my Hog Rider to finish it off. But the risky thing here is if I use a fireball to finish that tower off, I'm probably going to get overwhelmed on the right hand side because I need those fireballs to take out all the barbarians and also damage those buildings. But now that we're in the double elixir period, things are starting to get pretty heated as he's able to drop down multiple buildings at once and build up a pretty strong army. And take a look at some of his card levels. His knight is level 11. Now let me know in the comment section below what the average card level is at 2,800 trophies, because like I said before, I don't play this account too often. The last time I played on ladder was about a week and a half ago, and I still get surprised seeing level 11 commons down here when on my main account in Legendary Arena, that's the card levels that I see. Gonna go ahead and use the Valkyrie to take out the knight as well as some archers and hopefully damage the bomber, but unfortunately she does die before she gets a hit off on the bomber. Gonna go ahead and use the Zap Spell just to weaken that bomber and give the musketeer some time to finish it off. Here we are with only 11 seconds left, fireball going down, damaging both furnaces as well as the Barbarian Hut. 680 health left on my tower, and thankfully my opponent doesn't have a rocket or lightning spells in his deck, able to get the one crown victory. Let's go ahead here and do some live battles. So here we go, facing off against level 9. Give him the old thumbs up, good luck. Things are pretty crazy here, guys. Honestly, it's really tough to push into Legendary Arena. But I probably should play this account more often if I wanted to really focus and get it done. But level 8 giant. Ooh, this is going to be tough. This is going to be tough. Lucky the ice spirit freezing that, though. I think we might take that tower, guys. Because the giant plus the inferno tower means he spent like a bajillion elixir. So I think let's spread things out in case he poisons. But this level 8 giant is pretty tanky. I will be honest that my level 7 giant does die pretty fast, but his fireball one-shotting my musketeer. This is going to be a fun battle, guys. I've said this before in the past, that a musketeer with one health on it still does 100% damage, and on defense, behind a tower or whatever, It can come in clutch, so having an opponent that can one-shot your musketeer with a fireball makes a pretty significant difference in a battle. Let's go ahead and zap all this. The Valkyrie should tank for a couple seconds. Come on, come on, come on. Then we're going to go ahead and do a Hog Rider Ice Spirit push. Don't Infernal, please. Please don't Infernal. Yes! Look at that! Hog Rider know what's up. He's like, Infernal? Take out the tower, that's what's up. So thank you, Hog Rider, for knowing what's going on here. Let's go ahead. I want to play super defensively for the rest of this battle. But the thing is, I don't know if I can defend for another 20 minute, 20 second story against a guy with level 8 Giant. Of course, without the poison and the electric pump being as strong as they were, it's a lot harder to get a Giant to the tower. I will admit that. I was playing around with a level 7 Giant doing some friendly battles earlier without a poison spell, without a pump in there. And it feels tough getting a giant to the tower because... Sorry, I got distracted there. Because everyone's using Inferno Towers right now, like they're using fast cycle decks with Infernos. So it's tougher to get past that Inferno Tower without the poison spell slowing it down. I know my commentary sucks here, guys. I do apologize about that. But I'm honestly trying to focus on winning this battle here because I'm trying to make it to Legendary Arena. This is getting serious here. But I'm feeling pretty safe here, guys. I'm feeling pretty safe here. We have a 2-crown lead. Maybe we can 3-crown this guy. Can we 3-crown at level 10? Level 9, sorry. Zap all this. Boom, zap. One more hit. Hog Rider? No, no more hits. No more hits on that tower. What do we want to do here? Inferno Tower? Is he seriously worried about being 3-crowned? Okay. I will do this, and I will do this. Not enough time there, though, but we do get the 2-crown victory. Definitely okay with that. Hit him up with a good game. Let's go ahead here and do another battle, guys. So here we go once again. Please no level 10. Oh, level 10. Crying face, and wow. Gonna be a fun battle here. Now, of course, I wanted to do this series with a different deck every video, but with the meta changing in the last update, a lot of my cards aren't really up to the level that I would need to be able to use them effectively. Like, I don't even have the miner on this account, so to do a miner cycle deck. Is this Valley right here? Boom! Boom. By the way, Skeleton Army plus Ice Spirit kills Valkyrie. So, if you're curious about that, it do. Let's go ahead and Goblins to support. Fireball this. Can we save the Musketeer? One hit on the tower. Boom, there we go. So we got a hit on the tower, but his tower still has more health than mine does at 100%. What do we want to do here? Ice Spirit? We'll zap for good measure. Good thing I zapped there, guys. Good thing I zapped. But those minions still doing, like, so much damage. Only two of them. Let's go ahead and Hog Rider. We'll Fireball for the Skeleton Army that's incoming. Boom! No Skeleton Army. Waste of a Fireball. There it is! Thanks for using the Skeleton Army now. Would have really appreciated it a minute ago. But Valkyrie here. Boom. There we go. The Witch, though, doing work to that Valkyrie. Now, I spent a ton of Elixir there, so I have to be really safe here, guys. I have to be really safe here. Huh. Because things could still go either way. My tower's at 1700 health, and it don't take long for those level 10 cards to do that much damage to a tower. No, it don't. Definitely not. Let's do one of this. Freeze that tower, please. No, unfortunately, here's the thing, guys. With his tower being level 10, my Ice Spirit being only level... level 8, I cannot kill. Let's do this and this. Ice Spirit in the back. The Ice Spirit will not make it to the tower by itself, whereas normally it would. Oh, look at that value. Zap that. Look at that value. Fireball this? No, Valkyrie, wake up! Oh my god. It honestly felt like his freeze lasted a million years. There we go. We're dead, guys. We are dead. We don't have the card levels to beat this guy, guys. We do not have the card levels. Level 10 Barbarians. Everything is just too strong for us to take out. Plus, a couple big misplays by myself. We are going to lose this battle, guys, unfortunately. Hit him with the crying face. Hit him with the crying face for sure. So, battle lost there. Let's go ahead and do another battle, though. Don't give me the thumbs up, buddy. You're level 10. So here we are, guys. Final battle of the video. Another level 10. Just my luck. This is going to be another fun battle here. Let's see here. Now, I said before that I'm going to do all these battles, like, live, because that's what you guys wanted. Live replays and stuff like that, so I want to show you guys how tough it can be pushing into Legendary Arena as a lower level. You hit this wall where all of a sudden everybody has, like, insane card levels. I have calmed down a little bit, though, ever since that last replay. Don't hit one shot. Oh, one shot. I love one shot. I love one shot musketeer. Hashtag raging with Shane in the comment section below. Lots of people using the log, guys. Ever since the recent update, literally, I've seen so many log decks. In fact, there's a expo deck. Don't hate me for this, but there's an expo deck that I kind of want to use that has the log in it. It has, like, the log, the bowler, the expo, obviously. And it focuses on, like, pushing everything back away from the expo and protecting it. But I don't have the log on any of my accounts yet. So things are really not going good here, guys. Really not. Let's go ahead and do this and this. We'll see what he has for defenses. Inferno. Those goblins should distract for fairly long. I won't need the Zap spell. Doing good damage with that Hog Rider, bringing it down to 1700 health. I'm definitely okay with that push. Let's go ahead and Valkyrie here. Hopefully he won't fireball a Valkyrie. He might, I don't know. He is, okay, well, if that's what you want to do. Personally, I don't think it's value, but that tower is weaker. He shouldn't have it available for the push on the left there. We'll go ahead and do a Hog Rider with one of these. Like I said before, the Ice Spirit will not freeze a tower when it's level 10 as a level 8 Ice Spirit. At tournament standards, the Ice Spirit can get to a tower, but not on ladder. This is why I prefer doing challenge battles on all my videos now instead of ladder, because I find challenge battles to be so much more fun and a true test of skill. Let's fireball this Hog Rider here, and we'll have... I don't want to use that Zap Spell just yet. The Hog Rider for the Inferno Tower was a one Electric positive trade, so I'm still okay with that, because all I need to do is a Fireball here to finish that tower off. And the Nicholas from Alpha Centaurus is going to lose here. Fireball directly on the tower with nothing next to it. Let's go ahead and use a Cannon right here. Ice Spirit right here. Then we're going to play with this guy for a couple seconds and go Thumbs Up Fireball. Fireball. There we go. Good game. There we go. He was 2,900, so how many trophies do we get? We get 38. I'm definitely happy with that. Currently sitting at 2,833, which is my new personal best, by the way. Only 167 away from Arena 9. I might do a couple battles off video because things are getting pretty tough right now, and I always get a little bit distracted doing commentary and battles at the same time. I might do like one or two battles, maybe get to 2,900 off video, and then do the final push on video. But let me know what you guys think. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to leave it a like and also subscribe for more Clash Royale content. Thank you so much for watching, guys. We will see you in the next video. We'll be right back.